Did you know you can do this in Batman Arkham Knight? Recently in comics, Batman has been one-shotting people with his grapple gun. But did you know you can do the same in Knight? When an enemy rushes at you, the game tells you to throw a batarang, but you can actually use your bat claw instead, and instantly knock out the opponent. Subscribe if you enjoyed.
This is why there was no Slade physical boss fight in Knight. Narratively, it was not possible. Batman and Knight had already surpassed Slade by a long margin. I know a lot of people did not read the tie-in comics and played the mini Arkham games and read the guides of the Arkham series. If you had then, you would understand there was no way for a boss fight in the game without nerfing Batman. You see, Batman is physically stronger and faster than anyone in the game with the exception of Nightwing. The only character that had a chance in a physical fight with Bruce in Knight was Killer Croc's enhanced mutated body. Batman surpassed Slade before Arkham City and in Knight with his. Lighter gear allowing for faster and unrestricted movement was just too much of a beast for anyone to tackle head on. Pretty much everyone comments on how fast Batman has become in Knight. That is why villains opted for a strategic approach rather than a physical one. Imo, they should not have scrapped Prometheus from Knight, since he would give Batman a real challenge with his copy abilities, a lot like Taskmaster from Spider-Man. How Jason was captured by Joker, in most comics, and shows it's because he wants to prove something or being hot-headed, but in the Arkhamverse, it's completely different. Deranged and extremely sad, Joker the Mad Clown and Harley Quinn kidnapped a bunch of kindergartners. Jason, being a remarkable detective, tracked the Joker, but as he went further and got closer and closer, following a trail of blood, innocent's blood, Jason, horrified by sight of the children's bodies stitched together, he came to the conclusion that there is no prison, no madhouse secure enough to hold this demon, disheartened by the sight of a mother trying to piece together what is left of her child, broke Jason. Jason pinned down Joker's location and disabled all communication and tracker devices. He was planning on finishing Joker, but decided against it in honor of his mentor and father. Figure, but the clown ambushed Jason, breaking his bones, ankle, teeth, all the while singing Humpty Dumpty alongside Harley, which it angers me considering how much they push Harley forward in the Suicide Squad game after all the hideous things she has done alongside Joker, and not get punished for it. Did you know that Ra's al Ghul was actually behind the reopening of Arkham Asylum? Way back in Batman's early years, it's common knowledge that Ra's al Ghul was responsible for Arkham City, but now also Arkham Asylum. In Origins, there is a tape of Lady Shiva approaching Quincy Sharp and proposing him. The idea of Arkham Asylum in exchange, they would slowly but surely make him Gotham's mayor.
You say you want to be mayor, then taking this position is hardly a string.
So what did you say this facility was called?
Arkham Asylum.
Lady Shiva works for Master Kirigi, and Kirigi works directly under Ra's al Ghul, the demon's head. I have a theory on this. Maybe Ra's wanted to give Gotham a chance by helping the criminally insane get mental help in hopes of reforming them, since it's been said that Ra's was a good and compassionate man before the Lazarus Pit started deteriorating his mind. Perhaps he saw no progress and deemed Gotham a doomed city and begun plotting Arkham City with Doctor Strange. Did you know that in Arkham City, Batman indirectly kills two people? One is Joker, but the second is actually Clayface? Batman throws his sword at Joker, instead hitting the Lazarus mechanism, knocking Clayface into the Lazarus, and causing an explosion? This causes the Lazarus particles to mix with Clayface's DNA, therefore killing Clayface, but some say he was still alive, but unable to take form again. There are concept art for Clayface in Arkham Knight that could mean that he was a boss fight that ended up scrapped. But I have my own theory on this. In the prequel comic for Knight, Simon Stagg was trying to create a weaponized version of Clayface that drains life force and kept in his blips, but escaped and was stopped by Batman, but seemingly ended up being destroyed in the process. Tell me in the comments what you think of this.
How fast is Batman in Arkham Knight? The new bot suit enables the fear multi-takedown mechanic, where automatic gun turrets are perceived in slow motion that would put Batman's reaction speed to supersonic plus, but it's way greater than that. Catwoman actually dodged an arc of electricity shot by a militia drone relatively easily, while actually being caught off guard, and clearly Batman is way faster than Catwoman, Since he once beat her completely blind and relying on his other senses, this feat would put Batman in the massively hypersonic plus category, but more likely much higher since in his older Batsuits he was still way faster than Catwoman, so an Arkham Knight Batman would realistically be in the sub-relativistic to borderline FTL categories of speed, which is faster than light. Even though I did not like the Suicide Squad game, Batman's speed in it is crazier than in Arkham Knight. Did you notice this subtle difference in the design of the prototype Batmobile and the completed Batmobile? The prototype version has no protection on the side of the window, while the completed version has it in case a sniper tries to shoot Batman from the side of the car. Subscribe for more.
Did you know that Hugo Strange was actually the one who delivered Nora to Joker?
Where is my wife
being delivered to the Joker?
No!
And force Freeze to make a cure for him, but he was also playing a double game, because he is partially responsible for the Penguin and Joker war.
The clown. She really died.
It appears so. Yes, he is. He has Mr. Freeze working on a potential cure, but I am sure neither of us want him to get his hands on it, do we?
He is the one who tipped off Cobblepot that Freeze was developing a cure for Joker's disease, and if Freeze were to get captured, then Joker would surely perish, and Penguin would take over Joker's turf. Goes to show how much of a victim Freeze really was, and all that for his dying wife. He really doesn't deserve this. Subscribe for more DC lore.
Time never has been on our side, Victor.
Did you know that Batman and Mr. Freeze have only canonically fought twice in all of Batman's 16-plus years of crime fighting? They fought in Origins and City roughly 13-plus years apart. How is that possible, right? Simple Batman and Freeze may not be friends, but they are not enemies. Freeze only cares about his wife as long as no one messes with her. He's not causing mayhem. And by night, they seem to have developed some kind of mutual respect between them and somewhat become friends.
If you trust them, Victor, take your shot.
Find her, Batman. Please.
I will. Get the ship under control.
From that day forward, I swore I would dedicate my life to defeating those who would prey on the heart and the spirit of Gotham. So I became a symbol. Something even evil would fear. I became vengeance. I became the Knight.